Welcome to my quick assessment of the Soundpiece True Free Wireless Earbuds. These are a pair of true wireless earbuds. As you can see, they're housed in this black case. Right off the bat, one of my concerns was, well, you have no lid, but apparently Soundpiece did their R&D on these because the magnets in these are pretty strong. I've tried to get them out. I've only been successful once, once. And, you know, as you can see from the video, it's not going anywhere. So a lid is no concern. The only way this would be a concern is if, you know, water was to get in it and, you know, short circuit your earbuds or anything like that. The earbuds themselves would give you about 3.5 to 4 hours of talk time or music playback time, which is decent for earbuds these size. But the great thing is you always have this, you know, portable charging case that could recharge them up to 3 times, like as I said before. Let's show you what the earbuds look like real fast. I do like the form factor. They're not as streamlined as others, but as you can see, they're not too bulky. Let's get the side real fast. The fit and finish is pretty good. They feel semi-premium, but it's not slick. One thing I do enjoy about these, get this focused in. This is actually a button and not, you know, touch sensitive. I have a few pairs of wireless earbuds where it's touch sensitive, and when you're wearing a hoodie in the gym working out, you start sweating, it will, you know, activate Siri or Google Assistant, or pause the track, fast forward it, or call somebody randomly. That's annoying. So big ups to Soundpiece on that. Now this is really important before we pair them up. Soundpiece are actually Bluetooth 5.0, which means you can pair it to individual devices. Some other headphones can't do this. These are pretty great when it comes to that. So you could do the right ear on another, on a separate device than the left ear, or you could pair them both in stereo mode. So let's get these paired up. One thing I do wish the Soundpiece had before we get them paired up is that there was distinctive markings on each individual earbud for which was right and which was left. But, you know, maybe the next one. All right, so as soon as I pop them out, you're going to see that Soundpiece R pops up. This should be the right ear, hopefully. There you go, it's right. And I click on it, instantly paired, and there you go. That was quick. And now let's say if I want to attach the left to a separate device, I'll plug these back in, open this one up, take out the left, let's go into my Bluetooth settings. Actually, it's faster this way. Turn it on. Let me lower this brightness a little bit. Got a lot of stuff. Ooh, already got it paired in there, so let me disconnect that. And here you go. You will see that the left one is connected separately. Now, what does that mean? As you can see, the left is connected separately to this device. I play something individual on both at the same time so y'all can hear what it sounds like. See that both are paired. All right, let's leave the right over there with the iPhone and the left with the Galaxy. All right, let's go to some music. Let's play some Quincy Munford, Cruisin'. If Spotify will load. So this will be one continuous shot. All you could go to 2 Chainz, rap will go to the league. So right now, you're only hearing this one. Damn, Spotify. That was embarrassing, but whatever it is, I got the left. Let's jump to some YouTube. Let's see what's on the tube. What was I last watching? Oh, Beto. Now, as you can see, all you could hear, you know, the commercial from this video. When I grab the right one, which you would not hear, is anything. So, you know, separately paired. Now let's do it again. Let's go back into Spotify and see if it's going to act right. And we're going to get 2 different audio sources coming from both individual headphones. So right now you can hear both playing something different. Two headphones, different sources. All right. Now let's discuss the audio quality. With headphones like these, they're so small, you can't fit too many drivers in, which could compromise your sound. But Soundpeat did a good job on these, with the bass and the mids. The highs were okay, but big ups for the bass and mids. I listen to a variety of music, and for anything that I listen to, these are a go. Definitely a go, especially for the price. It's a budget pair of headphones. It's nothing like the iPods. You know, the AirPods, which are around $150, these are sub $30 headphones. Can't get any better than that. Now, apart from the headphones sounding good, you gotta have a great fit. It gotta be comfortable, and these definitely are that. I haven't changed out the tips on these. I've left the tips to the mediums, and you know, it's worked out fine for me so far. I will try the smalls. The larger a bit too big for my ear canal. These are definitely a go, especially if you're in the gym. You know, getting your powerlifting on, doing some power cleans or clean jerks or snatch or anything that may, you know, require your head to jerk a little. These definitely stayed in. All right, Dora. So, Dora, come here. What you think? Do you like them? Yes or no? Yes? Is that a yes? Is that a yes? Or is that a no? No? Okay. That's a yes? That's a yes. Oh. Finished pretty good. As you can see, no movement. Stands in my head. Shaking my head. Let's move. Pretty good.